Welcome back. Get excited, people. We're on the cusp of Every Time He Dies being published. To celebrate the publication of Every Time He Dies, which is gonna happen in just a hot minute on Tuesday, November 5, this week I'm going to share the 5 things you need to know about Every Time He Dies. But before we launch into this week's video, I wanted to remind you that the novel is still available for pre-order. It's available through Booktopia, Amazon, Book Depository, iBooks, Kobo, Barnes & Nobles, and a slew of other places. All the links are below, or head to taraeast.com. While you're there, why don't you try before you buy? And you can read the first 3 chapters for free right on my website. If you choose to pre-order a copy of the book, I will send you the first 5 chapters immediately as a thank you. That way, you don't have to wait until publication date to start your reading experience. Plus, you'll be able to enter my pre-order epic giveaway, which includes 3 grand prizes. These grand prize packs include 5 books, all signed by their authors. If you'd like to find out what these books are and a bit of a description, then please click the link up in the cards and watch the video I posted a couple of weeks ago. If I've rattled off all these details too quickly, rewind and watch again, or you can head to taraeast.com where you'll find all the details and all the information you need. In this week's video, I'm going to cover the 5 things you need to know about ETHD. Number 1, the novel is a hybrid novel. When you boil it down, Every Time He Dies is a mystery novel because the premise centers on a mystery. Duh. However, describing the novel in this way is slightly misleading. Every Time He Dies is not a tidy, read once, throwaway mystery novel. Oh no, this baby's got layers. She is about something. Every Time He Dies draws on multiple genres. There are elements of crime, thriller, horror, supernatural, mysticism, romance, and speculative fiction. Basically, it's Frankenstein's monster. It's a stitched-together beast whose parts I've pilfered from robbing various graves. But that's what makes it so damn beautiful, if you can put up with her lopsided smile. Number 2. Every Time He Dies is not your typical crime novel. This is kind of connected to number 1, but it's a little bit different. Even though the book opens at a crime scene, a double homicide, Every Time He Dies is not your typical crime novel. In fact, the crimes that occur in this novel pretty much happen offstage, and it's as a way to generate the plot and to move it forward. This book isn't about unsolved crimes, not really. It's about what happens when we bury our grief and when we isolate ourselves from our community, ourselves, and our family. What this novel is really about is characters and their relationships with each other. An early title for this book was Haunted. Not because the book had a ghost in it, but because all of the characters were haunted by their own past mistakes. Mistakes they could never undo, mistakes they could never fix, mistakes that they could never heal. This book is an exploration of how our mistakes can have huge ramifications and how we can move through them. Number 3, Every Time He Dies is really funny. After hearing me talk through points 1 and 2, you're probably thinking, damn, this book is really heavy. Now, all good books have light and dark. There are some really sad passages in this book, and there's some really moving ones too, but please know, this book is actually also really funny. I mean, how could it not be? I attached a ghost with amnesia to an embalmer who is suffering PTSD and who doesn't believe in anything woo-woo. I mean, that is excellent character fricken, people. What could be more funny? Number 4, research. I covered my research quite a bit in a previous video, which I'll post up in the cards, so go watch it. But it bears repeating. One of the elements that makes Every Time He Dies so unique is the amount of research that went into writing the book. I interviewed cops, psychics, mechanics, nurses, pharmacists, Filipino witch doctors, embalmers, funeral home directors, medics, detectives, and other crime authors. Basically, I bought a lot of people a lot of coffee. The reason I am telling you this is because I embedded all of that glorious knowledge into this book. As a result, the scenes are visceral and they're authentic. I describe the embalming process, the smell of the chemicals, the equipment they use. I go deep into the psychological ramifications of working the beat, and I've included colorful adaptations of stories told by Western and Eastern healers. Number 5, effort. I've made a lot of sacrifices in order to write this book, both financial and personal. I chose to invest in a master's program where students spend 1 year developing their novel under the guidance of established writers and teachers. I worked with a mentor editor who was brilliant, and I also hired a slew of professionals. I left my job and I moved away from home in order to rent rooms in different cities so that I could study these writing programs. Much to everyone's horror, I turned down a lucrative job in order to dedicate more time to studying and writing. And I haven't even touched on the effort that was actually required to write the damn book. I'm just talking about the logistics of it. Needless to say, I've totally lost count of how many revisions this book went through. There is only one scene, the climax, and the one paragraph that opens the book that are literally exactly the same today as the day I wrote them. Everything else in the book has been rewritten more times than I can count, but it was all totally worth it. When I started writing Every Time He Dies, I knew that I would be figuring out how to write a novel while actually writing it. It was a long and windy path, but I did reach the top of this summit. Now, there's no guarantee that the next hike and that the next novel is going to be any easier, but at least I have a map in my hand and well-broken-in shoes. So there you have it, guys. Those are the 5 things you need to know about Every Time He Dies. Be sure to pre-order a copy so that you can gain access to my 2 epic bonuses. There isn't much time left to enter my epic book giveaway, so get on it. While you're visiting my website, you may as well sign up for my email newsletter. When you do so, you'll gain access to my free writer's workbook, the Writers Kickstarter Pack, how to write a blog and get published. Thank you so much for watching again, guys. Don't forget to go pre-order your copy, and I'll see you again next week.